Cassie, whoever else out there. I'm going back here in Japan. Finally decided I'd get this video going too. It's been quite a while going. So my buddy Troy, using his video camera, we're getting this little production together. I'm going to take you on the tour of the station so you finally know what I, the environment I work in. I'll show you all the things and kind of give you an idea of what I do here. Tia, or whoever else, I shouldn't say mom, I'm used to saying that. This is the operations room. We conduct our normal paperwork and everything here. It's usually a mess like this, especially over there. This is Chris over here. He's from Florida. He's off the USS Dubuque. He just got back off deployment today.
St. Louis.
St. Louis, yeah.
St. Louis, and yes, it was today. This morning.
So he's glad to be there. I'm not usually in here because I'm usually in the operations room running the TV. Also, Mom, if you notice, Troy's using a tripod. I think it's something you should invest in. Because I got your package today with the second video in it and all the Christmas presents. Don't worry, I won't open up till Christmas. But, Mom, you definitely need to look into using a tripod. I think your video will turn out a lot nicer. Well, that's about it in here. Let's go to this is where I spend most of my time. I'm on nights and during the day. I spend most of my time in here running TV shows on the air. And the TV shows that we air, they go to both main base TVs and TVs out in Hario Village. That's a housing area for Navy personnel. Everything all right there, Troy? It's a housing area for Navy personnel about 13 miles away. And this is the only American station they get out there. They get it by closed circuit TV. So we run this out there for them. Basically, this panel right here is what I control everything with. These are just remote controls for VCRs that we run, like, all our programs in. Right now, we're running a movie, and that's just run out over the air. And we also run spots, like commercials back home. We air promos for, television shows, like, Tonight at 8 on David Letterman. You know, it's going to be Arsenio Hall and Johnny Carson on, whatever. And these are all the VCRs. There's six of them. We run everything out of. And basically, it's, just like the VHS tapes back home, except these use 3/4 inch, and they're a lot bigger. And these, what we're switching to, is beta. They're a lot slimmer and nicer. And they don't break as easily as these do. These are real old. A lot of these have been sitting in the warehouse for 20 years.
So show her what the 3/4 inch machine looks like.
Okay.
Compared to
this bigger one is a 3/4 machine to run these big tapes. These small ones are betas, and they can run big beta tapes, or small ones like this one, and also bigger ones about that wide. And I'll show you one later on. Okay, what else? Okay, over here is a satnet monitoring station. We have a satellite dish outside. It takes signals from Armed Forces Radio and Television Service Broadcasting Center in Los Angeles. And they send up a signal to a satellite, and the satellite downlinks it to all these stations in around the Pacific, and we're one of them. And it comes down and runs through all sorts of electronic equipment. It comes down basically right to here. Down to, there's a computer down there. And it runs out right here. And programs like this are timely programs, like Good Morning America, CNN Headline News, The Tonight Show, Dave Letterman. Things that, are timely events. You can't run them like maybe a month after they've been produced. So what we do is, when they're sent down, we record them. That way we can air a CNN headline news that comes down maybe 12 to 14 hours after it's been aired in the States, just somewhere around there. And that way we're still pretty much up on events what happens in the States, but we're just a little behind, and it doesn't make that much difference really. side.
VCRs or, you know.
Yeah, and we could also, if we're done with this and we want to end this, we can fade to black and be black. Although it comes over here, this is what's being recorded if you're using this on the edit cell. We can bring it back. We can do a lot of things with it. We can change the color of it. Change how it looks. You can change how we mix it down. You can fade it down like that. That's a little different. It just kind of fades out. It doesn't wiggle out like that.
Hold on, let me get a zoom in.
Okay. That one just fades out.
Basically, that allows us to do just about any effect that you see on most news programs back in the States. We can do just about anything they can, except for the turning page effect and real high tech stuff like that.
Okay.
As you can see right there.
Also, another thing we can do with it This right here is called A52, and we can do a lot of special effects with it. This is a pretty high-tech thing. I think this is one we've recently got. And we can do things like have it zoom in from the corner, like this, and just run out and come out and fill the screen. And we can run it back, and it moves back into place.
Wiggle it with the thing, the knob.
Oh, okay. One thing we could also do is do this manually. With this fader bar right here, you can do it manually if you want. That controls the rate of it. Something's definitely wrong with that. We'll call up a different effect on it. This one kind of spins around. Or we can take it off manual and just have it run it, have the computer run it, and that does it a lot more smoothly. What's another one? Also have these. I like these especially. That runs totally out of the screen. Comes out from nothing and fills the screen. And also have it come in from the top and out. Or we can have it come from the corner and back out. I know a little bit about this thing, not much to be proficient with it, but I've screwed around with it and known a few things about it. Do a little thing to everyone. I'm gonna do a little thing on the edit cell, just to show you how it works. Okay. This VCR right here, the one over here, is one that everything, all our effects get recorded onto that. So we usually put a blank tape in there. Okay. This console right here, the CMX, it can remote control all the VCRs. This is like the nightmare remote control right here. What we can do is we can look at whatever's on that tape in our VCR, and when we select it, it puts it up on the screen right here. We can also hit play from here. What's on this tape right now is old footage of a conference between the commander of the base
and the CEO of the Japanese minesweeper that was sent to the Gulf, and it just came back in port, and he was having an interview with him. I did that interview.
Exactly what I was going to say. But he's like, I don't want to look at that, so I'm going to put something else into it. What I can do is I can stop this, and I'll set it what's called an endpoint right here, and that sets an endpoint on the RVTR that I want my recording to come in at. I want to start my recording right at that point in the tape. And if I want to stop it, if I just want to have a little segment of it in there, I can play a little bit. Then I'll keep going in. And I'll stop it and set an out point. Logical. Okay, now those are set on my RVTR. This one right here. Now what I want to do,
as you can see, the computer there has taken the two points of the tape and held it, and it has stored it in its memory. So now it's held in that computer there. So that's like the master computer.
Okay. And now I want to look at what I want to put video, what video I want to put on that tape. And I select AVGR right over here. I want to put it in General Hospital. Okay? So I can stop this also and select an endpoint for it. And that's where I want my record, my video to start on that tape. General Hospital is over here. It's not on that tape yet. Also, another thing I can do is With this machine, I can choose if I want to put video on it, if I want to put audio, or everything, or just one of the two. I can select to put just video on it, general hospital video. Then it will have the captain and the Japanese officers talking with general hospital video on it. I could also put general hospital audio on that tape, which would have general hospital characters talking, but you see all the officers. Anyway, I'm just doing it to kind of explain how to do it. Everything's ready to go, I think, and I'll just hit record here, and I'll just select video. I have to reselect one of my endpoints. Okay, now we're ready to go. Right now what the machine is doing is pre-rolling everything 5 seconds. So it gives it time for everything to go. Okay, now it's recording. As you can see, it says record right here on RVCR. Now when it gets to the out point, it'll stop, like it did right there. Okay, now we can look and see what we did on RVTR. Select it here. Well, this doesn't have any audio, I guess. You can see here, the RVTR is playing. It shows the officers here. And they're talking, Canada down. And then we have general hospital video on that. They'll talk for a while. They'll go to black.
That just gives you a little indication of what the edit cell does. Right now we're in the radio studio, and I don't spend a lot of time in here, except I'll be producing a lot of stuff for production. And this radio studio, it's a lot like commercial studios, except it's a lot smaller. And but we can still do a lot of the stuff the radio stations do back home. Right now, let's see if we can get some up here. Right now, this is we're not doing this. This is from, Yokota Air Base out near Tokyo. And they send this down through, over the wires. They don't. Is that through the satellite too?
No, it's by satellite. It's maybe just by satellite, I think.
Well, anyway, somehow we get it down here. And, they run this 24 hours a day around the clock. And also, if we want to do something in the station, there's one of these switches back here will give us control, and we'll put out whatever we do on this board. So right now, we can do anything to the board, and it won't go out on the air. That way, we can still produce things without breaking into the airwaves, which would not be good, let me tell you that. A lot of times I've been in here doing something and I screwed up and I just, yell at the top of my lungs and say a lot of nasty things. But we can do a lot of things. One, we use mostly CDs. We have a lot of records in the operations room, but we use CDs a lot too. And to use CDs, everything has a channel on here, just like a TV. If we want to play, this is CD machine number one. And if we want to play this, we go on the, what is this called anyway? Anyway, the mixer board.
It's a mixer board.
And we can put CD number one channel in program and select a song and play it. And right now we can't hear anything because it's potted down, we call it. This is just a potentiometer, and if we pot it up. Control the volume, it's out from the speakers. Anyway, if we had that switch flipped up, and with this CD going, Harry Connick Jr.
Please.
Would be going out.
Go ahead and demonstrate.
No, I don't think that would be very good.
Senior Chief would like that. But Senior, we were just showing John's
making a video. I do not think they like that. We can also, there's channels for turntables in here. We use a lot of vinyl records for that. Here's our microphone.
Piece of junk.
And these things right here, these machines, are called cart machines. And these cart machines, all these things stacked along the wall, are carts. And these are made, when we record something on this, we record audio on here, just like we would a normal tape recorder. But the tape in here is a continuous loop. So once it plays, it goes back to the starting point and stops.
Not like an 8-track.
Yeah. For those who remember 8-tracks, I sure don't.
You don't?
We'll get cart machine. No, I don't remember that. Anyway, we get cart machine 3 up here. We'll turn it on. It's ready to go. Stop light is on. And just hit it off, we start it.
Something sinister is lurking in the shadows. Indiscriminate and dispassionate.
This is just a 60-minute spot. We put in our radio shows between the hours of 6 a.m. and 9 a.m. and 3 and 6 p.m.
It can turn a
beautiful day. We have two people in the station that do radio shows. They flip that switch up there and do a show. We do a show,
as a housing resident,
just basically a radio show. And we use these for like commercials. They're spots about, you know, like drunk driving and keeping in shape and weight control, fraud, waste, and abuse in the military.
Keep stairs and hallways well lit and clear of potential hazards.
When this cart gets done, right now it's going out and it's still running. And when it gets to that starting point, it'll stop. And so when we want to use it again, we just hit start again, and it'll start up again. And I'll show you how we use this as a mixer board, how it got its name. We'll play this song again on CD1, channel 1. Go for it a little bit. Okay, that song is going. I'll get another card real quick. Here's one card I produced for the Showboat promos. It's we have Showboat Theater on bass, and I do the promos for it. And they're aired on radio and on TV. Now hit this off. The audio is going through it. Now I'm going to mix the two. Bring the CD down. Bring the card up a little bit.
Friday night at the Showboat Theater is Child's Play 3. It's rated R and showtime is 7 p.m.
That way I can
at 9:15 p.m., Jean-Claude Van Damme stars in Double Impact. It's rated R.
Right
at the Hario Village Theater, Tina Reeves stars in Bill and Ted's Bogus Journey. It's rated PG-13 and showtime is 7 p.m. At 9:30 p.m., Michael J. Fox stars in Doc Hopwood.
It is stupid.
It's rated PG-13.
Then also mix it.
Saturday matinee at Hario
Village. Mix the cart machine down. Return of the Jedi. CD back up.
Do it a couple times so they can just, because I got a close up on it.
Cart machine, which is done. I'll bring up the CD again. We have the TV, channel 3, set up for it.
As you have already guessed,
this is a movie where Lady Hawk. And we can monitor it in here through the TV channel, the audio channel that goes through here.
Poor dumb creatures with no memory of the half-life of their human existence.
And
never touching in the flesh.
Basically, that's about it on the mixer board. There's not a lot of things a mixer board can do, but if you're intimate with it and you know how to use it, you can use it pretty well.
Whoa, Ma.
right now we're in the studio. This is where Troy and Brenda sit when they do the news. Right now you're looking at a teleprompter, which is a television and a mirror that's sitting in front of the camera. And this is how when people like Bob Bowie and Mel Maines, when they're back home doing the news, they look off the teleprompter. And that way they can look directly into the camera and read the script, read the copy they're going to say. It's just a TV projecting up in front of the camera with the mirror that's at a 45 degree angle. And, well, not actually a mirror, it's just basically a pane of glass. And the copy on the TV reflects up into the pane of glass, and that way it doesn't go reflect into the camera.
Of course, it's backwards.
Yeah, it's backwards on the TV because, you know, when you look in a mirror or anything, you see everything backwards.
You can see the camera behind the pane of glass here.
A little bit. Troy will go back behind, maybe, if he's good. And go back and show kind of what it looks like. There he is, going back there. Big camera back there. Whoa. We have two cameras when we do news. We have one over there, which is like, gives a panoramic view of the set, the studio set, and one, what's the word I'm looking for? The talent camera, I guess.
And it gives you a close-up. This camera usually gives us, like you said, a panoramic shot. Like, you get part of the desk and most of the background. We usually use that for our credit roll. We run the credits over that shot, and then the camera over here is the one we use for basically the entire newscast. As you can see, this camera, it's basically just we don't have studio cameras. This is basically an old 3/4 inch camera. Like, he showed you the tapes for 3/4 inch. These are the old 3/4 inch cameras. This is the teleprompter you see. It's just the computer, like you said, that projects onto a pane of glass. These are our new pedestals. By turning this wheel, I can move the camera any way I want to, but we got all kinds of wires in the way here, so we can roll it just about any way we want to. This, we have a pan and tilt friction, which allows us to pan up and down, adjust the friction, and that's basically all there is to the cameras.
Yeah.
Pan around back to John here.
Over here, this is where the talent sits. This is the new set with the vibrant gray background here. And the news logo's going around. It's kind of old, but I think we might be getting a new set, but I doubt that's going to happen. But the news person sits here, and during the news, I'm usually running video, which means I run the video for the stories and everything. And Brenda, she's the only Marine here, thank God. She does the news part, and Troy, who you just saw, runs is the sports guy. He's the sports god, I should say. And they sit back here and they type their script in beforehand, and then they just use the teleprompter to run everything out. I don't know if you want to get a shot of that.
I already did. Though it looks like people are reading off cue cards or even memorizing scripts, we're not.
Yeah, sometimes it's kind of tough. You know, if you type something in and you misspell a word and you make a stumble, it's usually kind of noticeable, but most everyone in here is pretty good at catching that stuff.
Sometimes. Not me.
One weird thing, though, they usually read better when we do a live newscast, when we do a recording, because a lot of people screw up on that. And we go also in the studio are these 3/4 inch tapes over here. Let me quickly. Can you see everything all right?
Yep.
All these tapes, we have, I don't know how many racks of them. These are 3/4 inch tapes that are the stations. And there's programs like Star Trek, Barney Miller, Kojak we're airing right now, pretty old stuff. There's also older movies in here, videos. We air in-between programs. And these, we can use to fill times during the day that we have nothing else coming in from from the TW packages. And TW packages are these things right here. These big hefty things. They come in sets of four from AFRTS in Los Angeles. And they're sent around a cycle of stations. Like they send it to the first station in the line, and then when they're done with it, they send it to the next station in the line. And FEN Sasebo here, we're about the eighth station in line on our circuit. So our programming right now is about seven or eight months behind what it is in the States. And these have programs like, the hot shows, I guess you call them, like Oprah Winfrey, not really hot, but they have L.A. Law, In Living Color, The Simpsons, Cosby Show. They also have some movies in there we air. They have cartoons in them, and we have two soaps, General Hospital and
Guiding
Light, we air right now. And these come every week, and when we're done with them, we ship them out to whoever is next on the line. I'm not sure about that. But I'd say we probably have,
I believe it goes to Korea.
Korea?
Yeah.
I'd say in our library we have about maybe 2,000 tapes. Somewhere around between 2,000 and 3,000, I would guess. We have quite a bit of tapes. And, let's see what else. That's about it in here.
Hold on, this is the view outside my room. The barracks overlooks the Sasebo River right here. The boats are in. And we're filming the next day. Everything's pretty it's pretty slow today. Right over here, that's the fish market. Every morning from 3 in the morning till about 9, that place is teeming with people. Up there is Mount Ibashi, overlooks Sasebo. That's downtown right there. That's going on towards Nagasaki. That boat down there is a boat that goes out to Hirado Island. They have some Christian churches out there that the Dutch settled way back in the 17th century. This is just what I see every day from my room. Pretty nice day today. About 60 degrees. Look at some of these cars here, Mom. Look at that little thing. There's a normal car, like we would have. Small little truck. You see a lot of these little pickups here. Just like, they use them for pickup trucks. Just like we do in the States. Some of the boats. Whoops. I can give you a little close up of them. Going on there today that I can see. There's someone. See that little gap. Usually there's an older guy out here fishing today. I don't know where he is. But you sit on the pier about right there. He'll just fish all day off that thing. This is Nimitz Park. This is where we have our ball fields out here. Also play football out here. This is outside the base, just outside of crossing. There's a ball field over there. There's a grandstand. And there's a tent set up out there. Little pavilion. A lot of beer fests go on there. There's some Japanese Navy buildings behind here. Our beach volleyball court. And another ball field. This is a little league field. Up there is Mount Yumahari. Whoa. There's an observatory up there. That building up there is an old